Wow, okay, so the world has changed hugely since my last video. As some of you know, I actually work from home and I have done my whole professional life. I actually really enjoy it, working in a nice, quiet, personal space, working on Setseed CMS. Suits me really well. So over the years, I've done a lot of thinking and experimenting on trying to find out what the ultimate format is for working from home. So this video isn't going to be like a show and shine video of a nice office, which a lot of people seem to be doing at the moment. Instead, we're going to do quite a deep dive and work out what choices we can make to increase productivity and comfort, and ultimately, you know, day to day, work harder and faster whilst staying healthier and happier. So this is going to be a series of four videos. So please like and subscribe and ring the bell to be the first to see them. So let's start by exploring where in the house is a good place to work from home. So if you've got your own dedicated room that you can call your office and close the door, that's great. Skip to the next video, that's going to be on ergonomics. But for those of you that don't, this is going to look at what you can do in a normal kind of house to create a really nice, quiet, positive working environment. So with schools closed, you're likely to have your kids running around in the house, so it's really important that you can work in a nice, private, quiet space where you can concentrate without the kids distracting you. And of course, that rules out working in other areas of the house, like the lounge, where the kids are probably going to be. So you're sorted if you've got your own separate room that you can set up for an office, but if not, you might want to try the hack that we've done in this house, which is to use the dining room as an office. So obviously that leaves nowhere to eat. So what we've done is moved the dining table into the lounge, and we've got a nice lounge diner and then the home office over here, and it works really well. I'd even actually suggest, if you haven't got a separate dining room in your house and you've got a kitchen diner, it's actually worth thinking about just whacking up a partition wall and creating an office space and then going for the lounge diner idea. So we've taken this idea a little bit further and we've made the office convertible into a home cinema, and at the weekends in this lockdown environment, that's really useful. It's great, we can all pile in here and watch a film or play on the PlayStation. So the magic of this comes from me pursuing the idea of using a bigger screen further away for my computer use. And that's based on the idea that obviously the closer you are to your screen, the greater the eye strain. So I've started using a big screen further away to avoid that. One thing we have done in the lounge, where the space is now a little bit lower because of having the dining table in there, is actually we've avoided using the typical TV on a TV stand setup, and instead we've gone for a wall-mounted TV in there with a floating shelf and an ultra-minimal kind of setup with just an Apple TV and a HomePod. So we've kind of been pretty ruthless in rejecting all the DVD players and recorders and paraphernalia that you normally associate with a TV. So we've got a very lightweight sort of TV system in there, and of course we've got the DVD player back in the home cinema room, so it all works quite nicely. So this whole dual-purpose office home cinema idea is working really well. We've had it for a couple of years since we moved into this house, and we're really enjoying it. It's a good idea.